Hey guys, welcome to this video on the volume of three-dimensional objects. Let's start off by defining volume. Volume is the measurement of how much space a liquid or gas takes up, or how much space a liquid or gas takes up within a given object. You may not know it, but people use volume every day. Volume is used to calculate drinking amounts. The amount of water you can hold in a cup is dependent on the volume of the cup. There are several other ways that volume is used. Now, let's take a look at how to calculate the volume of a triangular prism, a rectangular prism, a sphere, and a cone. The volume of a triangular prism. The area of a triangle is area equals 1/2 base times height. Essentially, to find the volume of the triangular prism, you're multiplying the area of the triangle times the length or the depth. So the formula for the volume of a triangular prism would be volume equals 1/2 base times height times length. Let's take a look. We have a triangular prism with a height of 8 meters, a base of 13 meters, and a length of 4 meters. All we have to do is plug our numbers into our formula, then solve. So we have volume equals 1/2 times base times height times length. And once we solve, we get our answer, which is 208 meters cubed. It's important to know that when dealing with volume, we'll always have cubic units because we're multiplying the units by themselves three times. Volume of a cube or rectangular prism. To find the same volume of a cube or rectangular prism, you will use the same formula. Just like with a triangular prism, you want to find the area of one side, then multiply it times the length. However, it's important to know that the formula you use to find the area of a triangle is not the same formula used to find the area of a square or a rectangle. The formula for the area of both a square and a rectangle is area equals base times height. So, to find the volume of a cube or rectangular prism, you would find the area of the square of the rectangle, then multiply it times its length, which makes the formula volume equals base times height times length. Here's an example. Here we have a cube, which is a rectangular prism, but all the sides are perfect squares. Because it's a cube, we know that all of the sides are the same distance. So, all we need to do is multiply 10 times itself three times. This gives us 1,000 meters cubed. Let's try another. Here we have a rectangular prism with sides that are different in distance. We have a base of 12 centimeters, a height of 8 centimeters, and a length of 6 centimeters. Now all we need to do is plug those numbers into our formula. And once we solve, we get 576 centimeters cubed. Volume of a sphere. Now if you remember, the area of a circle is a equals pi times r squared. That is, pi times the radius squared. Well, to find the volume of a sphere, you will use a similar formula, but multiply it times 4/3 and switching the r squared to make it r cubed. Making the formula for the volume of a sphere, v equals 4/3 times pi times r cubed. Now, you can do what is called a proof to prove that this is the formula, but for now, we'll just go ahead and plug the numbers into the given formula. The sphere has a diameter of 20 meters. This is all the information we need to plug in and solve for our equation. We're looking for the radius, and we know that the radius is equal to half the diameter, which means that our radius is equal to 10 meters. When we plug 10 into our formula and solve, we get 4,188.9 meters cubed. Volume of a cone. The formula for volume of a cone is very similar to the formula for the area of a circle. However, there are two things added to the formula. To find the volume of a cone, you multiply times 1/3 and times the height, because now you have a height because you're working with a three-dimensional shape. This makes the formula for the volume of a cone, volume equals 1/3 times height times pi times r squared. Here's an example. Here we can see that we have a height of 5 centimeters and a radius of 2 centimeters. Once we plug in all of our numbers, we have volume equals 1/3 times 5 centimeters times pi times 2 squared. When solved, we have volume equals 20.94 centimeters cubed. Great job, you guys. Learning new formulas can be hard. The important thing is to keep practicing so that you're able to recognize which formula you need to use and to memorize the formulas. I hope this was helpful. Be sure to check out more of our videos by subscribing below. See you next time.